Children, we have seen the most critical circumstance of Lucas, who had no money to pay the amount for that new picture which was made by him. In that circumstance, Lucas thought of getting some help from his friend. So while he was turning, he found that his friend had already left him. After a while, Lucas saw his friend at a remote place of the hall and he laughed heartily. Actually, Lucas did all this bidding work only just for fun, but that fun activity which changed Lucas to be in that critical situation. This is what is the reason for his friend's reaction. Lucas was shocked and confused. He was thinking what to do next. In the meantime, lot of pictures also sold in that auction, but he didn't give any attention to the new pictures. He just simply recollecting his relatives' names to whom he could get amount as a debt. And also he was thinking about the possibilities of asking Christie's staff to put the pictures for a resale, but this is not fair completely. He was thinking this and that. People will never participate in those type of auctions without having any amount in their hand. So if he said, I don't have amount, better you shall keep this image for resale, in the sense the Christie's staff, they will never believe, right? So he was confused. At last the sale came to an end. The buyers were writing the check and giving instructions. Actually, Lucas also had to write check, right? But he wanted to be a last person among them, as he didn't have money to buy for the picture which was bid by him. In this place, unexpectedly, his friend joined him. While seeing Lucas' face, his friend closed his mouth with his handkerchief in order to hide his laugh. Lucas' friend couldn't control his laughing, so he disappeared again. So Lucas was the only person who was in dreadful situation to face that terrible incident. He never felt such foolishness in all his life. Suddenly, unexpected thing happened. What happened, you know? Our narrator, Lucas, heard a voice inquired him, "Sir, are you a man who bought that big painting which was painted by the artist Dobini?" Lucas replied to him, "Yes, I am the person who bid for that big picture." Then the person informed him about the dealer who bid for the picture for the first time for the amount 4,000 guineas. So now that man, he was talking to Lucas on behalf of the dealer, and he wanted to know whether Lucas would take 50 guineas and withdraw his claim on the picture. The man who talked to Lucas wore a green apron made by coarse woolen material, and he spoke in husky tone. So on behalf of the dealer, this man is begging to Lucas to withdraw this deal, right? Actually, what would be the real thought of Lucas? He didn't have enough money to pay for that picture. He just waiting for the moment to escape from the place. So this is the right chance for him to escape, right? So he felt very happy to hear the words from the person, and he considered him as a messenger of God, who was actually the messenger of the well-known dealer. See what happened here? Lucas didn't give up all of a sudden. He just asked him, 50 guineas was a very low offer. Why should I have to consider only 50 guineas? Like that, Lucas asked him. Though we are all good enough, in some of the situations we will behave like as if we are very cunning. So the same with Lucas also. He had a presence of mind to ask like this, and he also asked, is that the most he would offer? As that person was the messenger of good dealer, he can't give any surety to him, right? So he replied simply that it was not for him to say. Lucas thought that it was not wrong in trying for a bit more, is there? And he instructed the messenger to tell him that he would take 100. And finally, the narrator got that amount. Lucas was laughing when he found his friend, but this time his friend was very serious by seeing the check. This was completely unexpected, you know, that's why his friend was completely surprised about the luck that favored Lucas. Lucas' friend told Lucas not to forget him. Why, you know? In the beginning, we have seen that as he forced Lucas, he entered the sale room. While both of them they entered, Lucas didn't have enough money completely. He didn't have money to pay, right? Just for fun they started to bid, but at last, while leaving from the hall, he had 100 guineas. Because of his presence of mind, by luck also, he got this amount. So his friend told him, because of me alone this thing happened to you, so don't forget him just like that. For that, Lucas also replying that I will never forget you. Here one more meaning also is that in his critical situation, he left him alone, right? So by thinking of that also, Lucas said I will never forget you. Finally, Lucas got relieved from his mental tight corner. As he experienced this mental tight corner, he was telling to his friends that mental tight corner is too much to bear than the physical tight corner, by explaining his own experience. This is the story of our prose tight corners, my children. I hope you all understand. Thank you, children.